Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make a Space Invaders game with Scratch. So this is the finished game. Now let's start. First, you may want to rename your project. And the first thing, we will create all the clones for the invaders. So they are like 5x11 formation. So first, let's just create one row, which is 11 of them. They are not showing because they are all hiding. So there are 12 of them, and this last one is the master. And after finishing the first row, we'd like to move it to here. So it's ready for creating next row. And we need a 5 rows. And this one is the master, so let's just hide it. And don't forget to show your clone. Now, based on their row number, they should wear different costumes. So the first two rows, they are large invaders. The third and fourth rows, they are medium invaders. And the fifth row, they are small invaders. So let's create a variable called row. And this has to be for this sprite only. So in this case, it is for this clone only. So each clone will have their own row number. So we will tell the master to start from 1. After each row get created, we change row by 1 for the master. So when the master create all the clones, they will all inherit the row number from the master. So you will see now each invader has their own row number. To prove this, I can make a small script. When this sprite clicked, I let it to say its row number. So this is row 1, row 3, 4, 2, right? So you will see each clone, they all know that their own row number. So next thing, based on the row number, these clones will put on different costumes. So if the roll number is less than 3, that means it is 1 or 2, they are large invaders. If roll number is 3 or 4, they are medium invaders. If row number is 5, they are small invaders. Great. Next thing, we can make them start to move. We'd like them to wait until everyone get created, then start to move. So let's create a variable called game on for all sprites. And we set game on to 0 at the beginning. After everyone get created, we set game on to 1. And each clone, when they get created, they just wait until game on becomes 1. Also, we'd like them to wait a little bit more so the first row will move first, the second row moves second, and so on. So you see they move in a nice way. Next thing, every time they move a step, they will switch costume. So like those large invaders, they will switch between large 1 and large 2. Medium, they also have 2 costumes. Smaller, small invaders has 2 costumes also. So here, we will check its costume if its costume name contains number 1, they will just switch to next costume. But if the costume name contains number 2, they should switch to the previous costume, which is current costume number minus 1. They look great. So we'll stop here and please continue on part 2. Bye everyone.